Hey guys, welcome to this session by Intellipaat. The world of IT is driven by data as we know it, and the workforce behind it is full of data scientists and data analysts. Majority of the IT companies use data science and data analytics to make data a friendlier entity and drive businesses to success. And in this session, we'll be looking at various aspects of data science and data analytics. Before moving on with this session, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our upcoming videos. Now let us take a quick glance at the agenda. We'll start off with a quick introduction to the world of data and learn the basics. Then we'll do a quick comparison of data science and data analytics. Moving on, we'll look at the different skill sets of a data scientist and a data analyst. Finally, we'll look at some sample job descriptions and their corresponding salaries. Also guys, if you want to do an end-to-end data science certification, Intellipaat provides a data science architect master's course which you can take up and master all the data science concepts, and the link is available in the description. Now without any further delays, let us begin with this session.
So let's begin this session by checking out the introduction to the world of data. Well, as we already know it, big data has become one of the biggest component in the world of technology that surrounds us today. And thanks to all the analytics that big data provides us, we can pretty much gain insights from the data. And this can result in businesses which can glean, which can, you know, be superior, which can understand how the data works and then use it to its advantage. Well, we already know the amount of data that surrounds us. We have petabytes and petabytes of data being put out by these companies, and even they would require the same. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, when you think about it. So these are the companies who will use a lot of data, store all these data, and then go about making use of it as well. So this should bring us to the question of what data science is. Well, data science is a huge field which is focused on basically finding some actionable insights from a large set of raw data, large sets of unstructured data, and structured data as well. You might be wondering what the goal of a data scientist is. Well, a data scientist's main goal is to basically ask questions, look at wherever he can make use of the data, and know where the data can be put forth for, answer specific questions using the data, add emphasis, and find the right questions that he needs to ask towards the data as well, guys. So data scientists are basically concerned with all the data that moves into their hand from the data engineers, who engineer all the data and bring in the data to the firm. And these data scientists pretty much go on analyzing the data. Most of the time it's performing some sort of calculations, performing analysis, and eventually it involves applying machine learning, artificial intelligence, or any of these very big concepts to make sense of the data, drive future trends and whatnot, and so much more. And later this is passed on to the data analytics team as well, guys. So on that note, what do you think about data science? Head to the comment section and let us know. And this brings us to what data analytics actually is. Well, as I've mentioned, data engineers drive the data into the company. Data scientists work with the data to get it to a stage where data scientists take the raw data and convert it into information. And this information is used by data analysts, who pretty much go on processing these data and performing a lot of statistical analysis on all the existing data sets which is provided by the data scientists, or they may pick up something new and perform some analysis on the same as well. But then analysts also concentrate on creating methods where data can be visualized, because at the end of the day, the data is just numbers, right? So seeing just numbers might not make sense at all times. So converting these numbers into very good looking visuals, very good looking graphs, and driving meaningful insights from there to drive the business basically to success is the job of a data analyst. So this data analyst will find out all the current problems and establishes the best way that they deem fit to solve the problem. So the field of data and analytics is pretty much involved in, you know, solving all of these problems for all the questions that we do not know the answers to, basically. So when you're coming to think of this point of time, most of the questions we ask is because we do not know the answer to. But when you're talking about data, you can ask and answer tons and tons of questions, but at the same time, you need to use those answers pretty much to the same pace and the same trend of the business eventually to drive something meaningful from it, right? So again, this pretty much will lead to results, which will lead to improvements as well. So this brings us to the main highlight of this video. What is the difference between data science and data analytics? Well, the first main thing that you need to know is that, you know, while many people actually, change around these terms, data science and data analytics, and use it together, there is a very keen difference, because the main difference, in my opinion, is the scope in which data science, spreads its wings in and data analytics is good in. So we can consider data analytics to be a part of data science, guys. So data science is the umbrella and the data analytics is a part of that. So coming to the differences, well, data science is a complete umbrella term for a group of fields, again, which is basically used to mine large data sets, which basically means that we'll be, looking and hunting into large data sets and deriving meaningful insights from them. But at the same time, data analytics is a more focused version, which is basically, considered to be just a larger part of the entire process, because at the end of it, all the data collected by the data scientists can be used by the data analytics team to pretty much go about doing visualizations, analyzing trends, and so much more. So coming to the next point, it's pretty much think bigger picture, think data science, because data science isn't concerned with answering any specific queries with respect to a specific set of data. It works its scope in a very wide way. But when you talk about data analytics works extremely well when you have a small scope to work with, when it is focused and you know the questions which need the answer to. And these questions, the answers that you can derive from these questions are basically from the existing data which is already present. So this is another simple difference between data science and data analytics. Coming to the next one, well, data analytics is all about the present data and the future. Well, let me tell you, again, data science pretty much, produces broader insights as we've been talking about, and, that you should concentrate on the questions which should be asked based on the past data where you can mine the data and make sense of it. This is the data sciences team. But then coming to data analytics, here we basically, drive into, discovering answers to questions that are being asked at that very moment, at that very instant, to drive something in the present or to produce a trend or an analytics for the future, guys. So again, when we've been talking about scope, here's a quick reminder slide for you guys. Data science has a vast scope. It has a macro scope, while data analytics is more preferred for a microscope. So what this basically means is that data science is a more vast field, and as we've already spoken about how data analytics come under data science. So data analytics is used to do a certain set of tasks really well, and a data scientist can also go about doing all of these tasks as well. But then there are many other tasks for data scientists that a data analyst cannot do. And this brings us to the goal. Well, the goal of the data science field is basically to ask the right questions and get the right answers from the data.
Okay guys, a quick info. If you want to do an end-to-end data science certification, Intellipaat provides a data science architect master's course, and those details are available in the description. Now let us continue with this session.
But then the data analytics goal is to pretty much find some actionable data where you can make sense out of it and drive business decisions and more. And this brings us to all the major fields that we can go about using. You might have heard of the term data science in majority of the fields in today's world. Well, it is used in machine learning, it is used to achieve artificial intelligence, search engine engineering, corporate analytics, it is used in the field of medicine as well, it is used in the field of manufacturing, and so much more. Data science has its foot deep in today's world of technology. And coming to data analytics has been a boon to the field of healthcare, to the field of gaming, travel, a lot of other industries, again, manufacturing industries too, where the data requirement is immediate and the analysis and the analytics which goes with it is also immediate, guys. So this brings us to the question whether data science and data analytics are the best of both worlds. Well, think about it this way. The two fields basically, can be considered as two sides of a same coin, because again, when you think about it, it's one coin where their functions are extremely highly interconnected. But then there are two faces to the coin where they are actually a bit different from each other. And this brings us quickly to check out the skills of a data scientist and a data analyst, guys. So basically, a data scientist, as we have discussed, pretty much works with all the data he or she gets and applies a lot of mathematics on it, applies a lot of statistics on it, and so much more. To do that, the primary skill that a data scientist requires is pretty much having a strong knowledge of languages such as Python, R, SAS, Scala, and so much more. And the second thing is pretty much knowing how the person can work with unstructured data, because at the end of the day, a data scientist can be working with images, can be working with videos, can be working with music, or a text data, which is unstructured, and so much more. And then this brings us to some backend development, where the person, the data scientist, needs to have some knowledge over backend development with respect to databases, data warehousing, handling data on the backend, and making the backend talk to the front end as well, guys. And this brings us to the fourth skill, which is basically having the knowledge of machine learning and sometimes deep learning as well. Because at the end of the day, we can use machine learning and deep learning and all of these concepts to achieve artificial intelligence and make the data a little smarter. This brings us to the skills that make a data analyst. Well, a data analyst basically works with the data he or she gets, and at the end of the day, creates beautiful visuals out of it, gives us future trends, predictions, and so much more. Having the knowledge of statistics is one of the most vital skill for a data analyst, but then having very good statistical skills without implementing it in the world of computer science would not make sense. Hence, a data analyst would also be benefited if he or she knew a bit of programming in terms of Python or language such as R as well. Then coming to data wrangling, again, we've talked about data and we know how data can be so much messy, especially if it's unstructured, or data can be a very unruly entity, if you may. So data wrangling is again basically, you know, picking up all the data that you particularly require in a hunt. It's like hunting for a needle in a haystack, and data wrangling is pretty much something similar to that as well. And a good data analyst will have very good data wrangling skills, guys. And then at the end of it, a little bit of big data technologies are needed as well. You need to have knowledge of big and technologies like Hive and more. So to bring it all in one single gist, here is on the screen. So basically, a data scientist is responsible for working all of the raw data and converting it into valid information. A data analyst will be basically performing prediction and presenting all of these informations to clients and peers. Well, think about this scenario where a data scientist gives lots of numbers to data analysts, and then a data analyst is a person who can figure it out. He can convert the numbers into graphs. But then when you're going into a business meeting, or you're going into, say, you know, a board of directors meeting, giving them the numbers, they might not be able to make more sense of it. So basically, you convert these numbers and make them look into beautiful visuals, very good graphs, pie charts, and whatnot. And all of these eventually can make sense, because at the end of the day, a part of the data analyst's job is to basically convince a person who doesn't know the technology eventually about the data that they have been working on. So this brings us to a couple of sample job descriptions that I want to show you guys with respect to data scientists and data analytics as well. Well, the first job description I have is of a data scientist job description, and the company who's hiring is the New York Times. They require a PhD, MS, or a 3+ year experience in computer science, applied mathematics, or quantitative and computational discipline as well. Again, as we have talked about, mathematics is a very important part about a data scientist. Mathematics is a very important part of a data scientist job role. And then they'll require more than 2 years of experience with open source machine learning concepts, statistical tools, experimental designs, and so much more. Again, one of the most important skills they require is coding. So Python is preferred, or even R can do as well. But then the New York Times says they prefer Python developers. And then again, ability to communicate all of these complex ideas in data science to relevant stakeholders and making them understand of what's going on. And lastly, it's pretty much, you know, data engineering experience, where you can handle the data coming into the firm and then go on working with it. You will need to work with the data in the backend using structured query language, and you'll have to manipulate large structured and unstructured data, which is sent for further analysis as well, guys. So this brings us to a data analyst's job description. We have the job description from Uber. Uber is the very famous cab providing service across the world. Well, they require a Bachelor of Arts, Science, or Master's in Economics, Business, Engineering, Operations Research, or any other quantitative focus. And they require excellent analytical thinking, where you have the ability to see through the data, connect the dots between the data, and pretty much, you know, gut check every number you see. Well, gut checking pretty much means that you can go about analyzing these data and know that your data will perform well. And then since you're doing very good analytics, you will require extremely good Excel skills and some programming skills as well. Remember, we discussed about Python and R a couple of slides ago. That is exactly what Uber wants as well. And then experience with data visualizations and extracting insights from the data. So this is basically their core part of the job description, and then basic understanding of some statistic techniques and the ability to employing them in solving certain business problems are the second most important requirements from a data analyst. And this, in my opinion, is again a very good example of a data analyst job description, guys. So you might be wondering what the average salary is of a data scientist and a data analyst. Well, a data scientist gets an average pay of $120,000 in the United States and over 15 lakhs per annum. This is the average numbers. And then for a data analyst, it's around 90,000 American dollars in USA and about 11 lakhs per annum, guys. So these numbers have been squished down because of the lower threshold and the upper threshold from the data found across various sites. But then even a data scientist can earn up to 40 or 50 lakhs per annum, and a data analyst can go all the way till 30 lakhs per annum as well. So make sure that you check your relevant experience and you have extremely good certification so that you can leverage that and use it to get a very high paying job, regardless of it being a data scientist's role or a data analyst's role. So here are my final thoughts on the video. So basically, I have this quote, which is very nice, and I thought I would share it with you guys. So it says, it is very easy to lie with statistics, but it is extremely hard to tell the truth without it. So this quote is from a person called as Andres Dunkels, and I love the quote, guys. So what do you think about the quote? And again, at the end of the day, we also know that data scientists' role and the data analysts' roles are one of the most trending jobs in the world, which are present today, guys.
Okay, guys, a quick info. If you want to do an end-to-end data science certification, Intellipaat provides a data science architect master's course, and those details are available in the description. Okay, guys, we've come to the end of this session. I hope this session was helpful and informative. If you have any queries regarding this session, please leave a comment below and we'll love to help you out. Thank you.